Hello, in this video I'm going to be looking at C# 13 in .NET 9 and I'm going to be reading and answering some of my viewer questions and comments. That means there are two segments in this video, which technically makes it a podcast. Oh god no.
He's having a midlife crisis, so he started a podcast. It's Ted's Tech Show.
This is not a podcast, okay? Okay? This is a video channel. So here is C# 12 in .NET 8, and we have a simple class here called subscribers list. What we can do is use it like this: var subs list equals new subscribers list. And we have to do a really annoying string initializer like this, string collection initializer. Barry and Larry are subscribers. Then we can go for each sub like that. Var sub in subs list. Console dot write line sub, and we're accessing the property subs on that class. We then run the app here and it says Barry and Larry. Very good, but this is quite verbose, so let's copy and paste this stuff over to our modern .NET 9 C# 13 version. And obviously there, if we set the startup project to that and run it, we can see it's the same program. But we can make this better. So C# 13 now includes params for collections in constructors. So this can now be changed to simply Barry and Larry like that. And it's still a list because this iList thing has an add method. This is the same code, so that's quite nice. It's better than this version. And the only issue here is if you've got some code and you're going to be copying and pasting it between C# 13 and .NET 9 back into a .NET 8 project, you're going to have an issue. But hey, it's pretty good. So on top of that, partial classes have been improved. If we have something like this, a partial class called likeCounter. Now this is quite old-fashioned, you see. To use this guy, we have to do setLikes and getLikes separately, sadly, to do partial methods on this partial class. So in C# 12, to do this, we'd have to do this. Likes counter is new likes counter. And we do likes counter dot set likes 10. And we can do console dot write line likes counter dot get likes, like so. And if we run this, obviously it will say 10. Very good. Now, how can this be improved in C# 13? Let's find out. So we take our program. Copy it over to our C# 13 target. And obviously, if we ran it, same thing would happen. But let's make this partial class better. Having two methods like this is very old fashioned. So obviously, what we'd prefer to have is something like this: int likes get set. That makes sense. What you'll notice is that it's starting to complain here that it needs an implementation part. So what we can do is the following: public partial int, whoop, not interface, see, likes get but return likes. We can do our get a setter implementation. Set likes is value, like so. Then this actually now works, and we don't have to use partial methods anymore. We can just use partial properties. How good is that? So we can do this. Likes counter likes is 10, and we can write the likes counter likes if we set the startup project to our C# 13 version. We can run it and it says C# 13 and 10. Very good. And if we can compare that to C# 12 version, it's a little bit nicer, isn't it? In case for some reason you're doing partial methods or partial classes. Not quite sure why you'd do that, but if you were, you could use this. Pretty good. Next up, well, actually, that's kind of all that's worth looking at, to be honest. Here's a list of all the new stuff in C# 13, and the only things that will make a difference to your average developer are those params collections. And what I mean, why would you do this? I don't know. And if you're doing unsafe code, use a language designed for it. You're not going to do this. Partial members and the param collections are the only things in reality that you're going to come across or find useful in your average line of business stuff. Next up, I'm going to read your viewer comments after this commercial break.
Who's that MVP?
Nick Chapsis. Did he get it right? I thought that was quite easy. Every time I do a new video, I'm going to have another Who's That MVP? Got to catch them all. Maybe we should do the MVP rap at some point. Anyway, on to viewer comments.
They only watch the channel for free technical training. Shoot your viewer comments.
I promise this is not a podcast. Anyway, first user comment. First time watching you. Oh, this is from Country EN. Thank you. First time watching you, but instantly subscribed. Good taste. Interested in what else you show and tell. .NET was my first tech 10 years ago. Still using it. I agree with most of this. What about minimal API? Last, I think it's for beginners. It's much easier to start with. Well, the point of my video about what to learn on .NET was that there was something to learn, okay? The thing is with minimal APIs is there's nothing to learn. Once you know C#, you can write a minimal API. There's no conventions to learn. This is why I recommend learning MVC first, because there's actually something to learn. Every project that uses minimal APIs will eventually look completely different, and controllers will be reinvented. So ultimately, there's nothing to learn. Wouldn't worry about it. Next up, Sir Benjamin. Thank you very much. It's one of the worst aspects of software development. This is about the video, the Scrum video I just did. In every other industry, you're trusted to do the work, and it takes as long as it takes within reason. Yet in software development, we're pushed to come up with artificial deadlines just so we can tick a box. What should be more important is producing quality work. Well, yes. Worst bit is that you can't win. If you meet the deadline, they expect more from you. If you don't meet the deadline, it has consequences. This industry is treated really badly. Is it a profession? Should we even call ourselves engineers? I don't think so. If a bridge engineer said, I need another 6 weeks or the bridge will collapse, their boss would say, okay. But if a software engineer said, I need another 6 weeks or the software will suck, the boss would say, deal with it. How do we solve this? I don't know. Next up, Boskovich Boris says, you don't have to use the new features at all if you don't want to. This is in regards to my moaning about C# moving too fast video. So reading other people's code is not a thing. Thank you. If your job involves diving into lots of different C# projects, you have to know every single nook and cranny about C#. It's annoying. This is my job. I'm a consultant and I have to read lots of different C#, and it's almost unknowable. I don't think any one person can now know every single bit of C# syntax ever. So yes, Boris, thanks for the comment. Tito Babette echoes this. Evolving language is fine as long as it's not a breaking change, but the support cycle is a deal breaker. Correct. 6 years would be a minimum for me. Yeah, I'd like a 6-year LTS for .NET 8 or 10, please. If you ship an app in the last year of .NET 9, you've got about 1 year of LTS left. That sucks. And .NET Framework 4.8, I think, is having a renaissance, actually. The fact that it's built into Windows, no runtime download. They haven't actually put the .NET 5, 6, 7, 8 runtime into the Windows install yet. Don't know why. I think .NET Framework is pretty good. If I'm doing utility apps, I need to make sure work on every single version. Deployment of Windows, just use .NET Framework. Simples. And D Rancid says, what about learn MAUI for mobile development? What do you say, please? I use C# for script, Rhino 3D and Grasshopper. Your videos scare me a lot. Yeah, they scare me too, mate. Have you seen them? I don't want to learn new languages. Yeah, fine. Okay. Well, actually, guess what? Thanks to the magical power of AI and LLMs, large language models, and GitHub Copilot and stuff, I think doing mobile app development in a language that you're not familiar with, so Swift, Kotlin, etc., is actually 100 times easier than it used to be. The point of MAUI, for example, .NET MAUI and other cross-platform languages, was that somebody that doesn't want to have to learn Swift or Kotlin or Java or whatever can build an app for iOS and Android in C# using their existing C# skills. Don't have to learn anything new. I'm just a C# developer. But now, you know, that's a, it's a lot easier. I mean, you can use an LLM to translate code between the two. If you've got, they've just done GitHub Copilot for Xcode itself, that'll probably help you get there and learn about iOS development with Swift. So I wouldn't worry about it. Actually, now I would aim to build native mobile apps, not using cross-platform frameworks. I think that era is over. It's the AI-assisted, LLM-driven era. Thank you for watching. I will try not to make this too much of like a podcast, so don't call it a podcast. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you found that fun or interesting or informative. If you found it totally awful, press the like button 3 times, which is a super dislike. Thanks for watching.